chronic pain conditions like fibromyalgia still baffle doctors and therapists. Once considered a psychological condition that people just imagined they had due to intense stress, doctors now acknowledge there is something more to the silent destroyer that potentially involves the all-important nervous system and the elusive endocannabinoid system. Current research suggests that cannabinoids may help ease symptoms of fibromyalgia. Experts hypothesize that one of the causes of fibromyalgia is a deficiency of endocannabinoids, endogenous cells in the endocannabinoid system that bind and activate receptors to carry out their localized action. Endocannabinoid receptors are located all over the body, predominantly in the brain and the immune system. Receptors have also been discovered in the reproductive system and the digestive system. When a cell deficiency occurs, the receptors may not be able to carry out their dutiful role in the body. What happens? Well, when these receptors are not activated by cells, they do not perform their localized action when the body calls on them. ECS receptors are responsible for triggering off neurotransmitters to perform their role in the body. One such vital neurotransmitter is serotonin. Serotonin is mainly noted for mood regulation. However, serotonin plays a role in other bodily processes, including pain relief by regulating the pain response. If you have a chronic pain condition, the levels of serotonin are constantly being depleted. This is where cannabinoids come in. Cannabinoids mimic the action of endocannabinoids. This is how scientists discovered the system in the first place. They were trying to understand how cannabis worked in the body and discovered this unique system that governs so many actions in the rest of the body. THC mimics anandamide, the endocannabinoid that binds and unlocks CB1 receptors in the brain to trigger off neurotransmitters. Due to its psychoactive properties, people are skeptical to use it. This is where CBD may be the best choice. Although it does not have the same capabilities of THC, if there is a small amount of THC present, less than 2% from medicinal cannabis, CBD can still be of assistance without evoking the psychoactive high. CBD can boost levels of endocannabinoids in the body. It also participates in the activation of receptors to help reduce headaches and pain, ease anxiety, and promote the release of serotonin and dopamine. Some people find that when they take a daily dose of CBD oil, they are more creative and can concentrate for longer periods of time. CBD oil and other cannabinoids have the unique ability to potentially treat the cause, not just the symptoms of chronic pain. This is pretty exciting for those that have conditions like fibromyalgia, multiple sclerosis, and other pain conditions, even rheumatoid arthritis and autoimmune disease. I was diagnosed with fibromyalgia at the age of 16. At that time, I was put on amitriptyline. Now, if anyone has been on amitriptyline, I'm assuming quite a lot of people with fibromyalgia, you know what it's like. It is a strong sedative. It does help you to sleep at night, but you feel pretty miserable the next day, and it can have that residue effect for the entire day. I was on this for about 25 years old. At that point, I needed to try something else. I was struggling with everything. Things were getting worse because my symptoms of fibromyalgia were also getting worse. And then on top of that, I was experiencing this residue effect of amitriptyline. So I thought I'd try cannabinoids. Over time, I decreased my dosage of amitriptyline from 50 milligrams, slowly to 25 milligrams, then slowed down to 10 and then to 5. To now, I'm not on amitriptyline at all. I only take cannabinoids at night, and also might put some in my cooking, and it has helped so much. I still experience symptoms of fibromyalgia. This will never go away. But what I don't experience is that sedative, that horrible feeling that you get the next day after having amitriptyline. And that is huge for someone with fibromyalgia, because when you're struggling with everything else, the last thing you want is that sedative effect that just makes that foggy brain even worse. So if you're not sure, talk to your doctor. See what they say. I know not all doctors agree with it, and so it can be a bit difficult to get to find the right doctor, but I find that this works for me. It may work for you. Give it a try, but I strongly recommend to talk to your doctor before you do. Cannabinoids are not the only substances that could aid in improving symptoms. A healthy diet with plenty of fatty acids is considered one of the best ways to manage symptoms and reduce severity. Let's talk omega-3, protein, phytochemicals, vitamins, and antioxidants. Chet Cunningham, the author of the Fibromyalgia Relief Handbook, claims that a healthy diet provides you a psychological boost, knowing you're doing something to help fight your disease. Food is fundamental in symptom management. Consuming foods that increase inflammation in the body can worsen your pain. Consuming a diet high in simple carbohydrates and fatty foods and not eating enough protein, fruits and vegetables will impact your energy levels, ability to concentrate and impair mental health. On the flip side, a well-rounded diet, high in low-fat protein, fatty acids, fruits and vegetables and reducing sugar, processed foods and alcohol aids in reducing inflammation that leads to pain. A healthy diet also maintains energy levels, boosts brain activity, and eases digestive upsets. Omega-3s, vitamins, minerals, and protein are essential to feed your organs. Omega-3 is vital for the functioning of every cell of your body. Yes! Endocannabinoids are made up of fatty acids, and the brain is made up of 60% fat, the fattiest organ in the body, and it craves those crucial fatty acids to provide the correct fuel. Magnesium, calcium, and vitamin D are important minerals for aiding in the reduction of pain and participates in the regulation of melatonin, which in turn assists in the release of growth hormone to repair the body during the night. Stephanie Watson from Healthline claims that diets that are rich in antioxidants and provide adequate amounts of nutrients such as vitamin B12 can help lead to reduced symptoms. It can be difficult to get in all the right nutrients. If you are short on time, try my favorite power smoothie that is packed with all the essential nutrients you need to get your body into gear. Let's go. A scoop of whey protein powder, one Brazil nut for your daily dose of immune-boosting selenium, 5 teaspoons of chia seeds for fatty acids, calcium, iron, zinc, magnesium, and vitamin B3. Magnesium and vitamin B3 are especially important for the enzymatic conversion of omega-3 LLA to docosahexaenoic acid, an important fatty acid for brain development and function. 2 to 5 teaspoons of flax seeds for that amazing alpha-linolenic acid boost. 1 teaspoon of pumpkin seeds high in the amino acid L-tryptophan, necessary for synthesis of serotonin. 4 to 5 walnut halves, one of the healthiest nuts you can eat and also high in ALA. 8 to 10 almonds, another good source of magnesium, fatty acids, and vitamin E. Toss in a half a frozen banana, a couple of slices of pineapple, and a tablespoon of blueberries or other berries or fruit for their potent antioxidant and vitamin content. And lastly, a cup of milk of your choice. This smoothie packs a powerful nutritional punch you can have any time of the day. And the convenient aspect for the smoothie is that you can make it the night before or first thing in the morning, blitz it up and sip it throughout the day. One of the most noted benefits of cannabinoids and good nutrition is that they enhance the body's natural processes to get the job done. In my opinion, THC is not the problem. It is the amount people have, causing their body to actually rely on it to activate receptors instead of cells doing it, creating that body dependency or addiction. Understanding the way cannabinoids work can then enable you, through doctor's advice, to take the right dose for you, to not only survive with FMS, but to thrive.